So dito naman tayo sa next problem natin. A lightweight rope daw is wrapped around a drum and then the coefficient of friction between the drum and the ground is 0.3. Determine the maximum angle such that the drum doesn't slip. Also determine the tension in the cable for this angle if the drum weighs 100 newtons. So draw muna natin yung FBD. Dito mag-act yung weight, which is 100 pounds. And then since meron tayong rope dyan, we essentially have a tensile force. Yan, T. And then, this is 60. Divide natin yan by 2. Makukuha natin yung inclination niya from the horizontal. So, this is 30 pala. Yan. And then, ano pa? Meron tayong normal force acting dito. So, this is Na. And then, meron din tayong frictional force na nag-a-act dyan. So, parang this is mu multiplied by the normal force. So, 0.3 Na. Yan. So, ito kasi, yung first na isosolve, determine the maximum angle such that the drum doesn't slip. First, we can take moments sa center ng circle. Kasi, from the center, tangent kasi yan. So, this forms a perpendicular line. Saka, ito rin. So, if this is the radius, yan, then we can take moments about the center. Sabihin natin, C. So, summation of moments about C equal to 0. We have T multiplied by R. This will cause a counterclockwise rotation while 0.3 Na naman will cause a clockwise rotation about the center. So, iset na lang natin sila as equal. So, magiging 0.3 Na eto multiplied by R. So, magka-cancel si R. Yan. So, the tensile force is equal to 0.3 Na pala. Yan. So, lagay ko na lang din. By the way, yung Na, hindi nasali kasi kasi it acts toward the center. So, wala siyang moment arm. And so, yung best approach for this problem is, ano talaga? We can sum up moments, I mean, forces vertical and horizontal, but not sa conventional axis. Instead, dito tayo sa inclined axis para yung 0.3 Na hindi mo na i-component. Kasi mahirap kasi, yung mahirap dito is angle kasi yung unknown. Yan. So, let's say this is x prime. And then sabihin natin, itong axis na to, this is y prime. So, mas mabuti pag mag-sum up tayo ng forces dyan sa x prime saka y prime. So, summation daw tayo ng moments sa x prime. Yan. So, this is x prime, yung naka-incline. So, meron tayong 0.3 Na going to the left. So, 0.3 Na minus. And then, meron tayong components sa tension saka sa weight natin na 100 pounds. Now, again, para sa components, para alam mo yung sign, whether positive or negative, i-draw mo muna. Bale. Diba, ito yung x, ano pala, y prime natin. And then we have this force, 100 pounds. And then ito naman yung x prime natin. Yan, perpendicular. So, ano pala, if this is theta, then pag mag-draw tayo ng triangle, I mean line dito, yan, if this is theta, theta din to. Now, this is perpendicular, so this is, ano pala, 90 minus theta. Yan. And then, if this is 90 minus theta, pwedeng ito na lang din. Yung inclination niya with respect sa y prime, yan yung theta. Kasi pangit kasi sa solution natin pag merong 90 minus theta. Yan. So, this is theta. So, diba, pag i-rotate natin siya na pa-conventional, yan, gawin natin straight. So, parang southeast. So, negative yung along y prime and then yung along x prime is positive. So, yan yung importante sa inclination. And then for t naman, yan. Anong color ba? Ito na lang. Let's draw a line parallel to x prime. Yan na lang, para sure. And let's also draw a line parallel to y prime. So, ito. So, this is, pag i-rotate mo conventionally, parang southwest. So, yung component pala niya, along x prime and y prime, puro negative. Yan. And then, yung angle naman, para sa angle, paano ba? We can draw a line here. Ibang color na lang. Yan, so 30 yan. Ito rin. Then this line is, wait lang. D sine 30. Ah, okay. Ito na lang. Diba, pwede natin yan siyang i-extend. Yan. Now, this is 60. Yan buo. So, pinahirapan ko lang sarili ko. Ito lang pala. If this is 60, we can consider this triangle man. Yan. So, this is 30 pala. Yan, 30 degrees. So, again, along x prime, we have plus 100 kasi patungo yan siya sa right, southeast. So, 100 and then, with respect sa vertical, so, doble ingat lang, we have to use sine. Sine theta. And then, minus t sine 30. And again, with respect to vertical din yung 30. So, I have to set this to 0. Yan. And then, for summation of forces naman along y prime, I have Na. Eto. And then, meron tong component, yung 0.3 Na. Ah, wala pala. Purely horizontal pala siya sa x prime. Sorry. Itong 100 lang. 100, bale, 100 cosine theta. Pa downward, so minus. And then we also have, eto, t, still acting pa downward along y prime. So still minus t. But instead of sine, cosine na tayo. Yan. Ito kasi yung adjacent side sa angle natin. 30 degrees. T cos 30 equals 0. But again, alam natin, yung t is equal to 0.3 Na. Yan. So, papalitan na lang natin. .3 Na yan. Saka ito rin. So, yung pwede natin gawin is we can define Na in terms of theta. So, gagawin ko, I will isolate 100 sine theta. Yan. And then, i-join ko yung coefficient ng Na. So, coefficient ng Na would be 0.3. Pag i-move natin sa right side, magiging positive na yung coefficients ng Na. Diba? So, parang 0.3 plus 0.3 sine 30. Tama ba? Ano ba yung mas madala? If angle is unknown or Na is unknown. Ano na lang. Mas maganda pala pag yung angle yung first natin sinolve. So, gagawin ko na lang. Isolate ko yung Na. .3 sine 30. Saan galing? 0.3 yan. And then, ito naman, 0.3 sine 30. And then, I moved it sa kabilang side ng equation. Kaya naging plus. So, equal to sa 100 sine theta. Yan. So, Na pala is 100 sine theta divided by this expression. Now, di ba, constant lang naman yung term na yan. So, kukunin ko na lang yung value niya. So, 100 divided by 0.3 plus 0.3 sine 30, we have 222.22. Tama ba? This is minus din to. 0.3 and a sine 30. Yan. Yan. So, meron na akong term for NA. Papalitan ko na lang lahat ng NA dito. So, yan. Papalitan ko na to. So, 222.22 sine theta minus 100 cos theta minus 0.3 NA is ito. Yan. And then cos 30 equals 0. So, try down natin. 222.22 sine x minus 100 cos theta then minus 0.3 times 222.22 sine theta cos 30 set to 0. We have what syntax error? Yan, 31.297 or 31.3 approximately. And so since alam na natin yung theta, masosolve na din natin yung NA. So, 222.22 sine 31.3 NA pala is 115.45. Ano ba yan? Naka-newtons. But, hindi pa ito yung sagot natin. The question is, ano yung tension in the cable for this angle if the drum weighs 100 newtons? So, di ba, the tension in the cable is equal to 0.3 NA. So, T equals 0.3 multiplied by NA. So, itong value na to, just multiply this by 0.3, makukuha natin yung 34.63. Yan. So, tama na yung dalawa. Music.